Then we move to the final item, which is the kind of Conservators item. I think the officer collected the threat on it. I think she has left, or
was it Gary?
Is it Gary?
I can do it, Chair. I'll be brief.
Referred to by number only, the number on each of them. Their names must not be revealed for the sake of confidentiality and to safeguard these individuals. So we would like you to stay, Richard, but it's on the understanding that this is what you must do, so please do not breach that. Candidates are numbered and please refer to them. Gary, please go ahead.
Thank you, Chair. Okay, so what this is that these Conservative Liberal Camp appointments are every 3 years, and you have the City Council has 7 seats on the Conservatives of Liberal Camp, and in 2012 the Council agreed to adopt a new strategy of having 4 members of the public and 3 City Councillors, so it used to be 7 City Councillors were on for the City Council. So these come to an end on the 31st of December 2015. The Executive Council has agreed that we follow the same format that we did 3 years ago, which was put out an open recruitment process for 4 City Council seats on the board of the Conservatives of the Liberal Camp. So we went out to an open recruitment process in August. We went to 30-odd voluntary groups to try and encourage applications. We went to the river manager of the Conservatives to put adverts out along the riverbank. We got 12 applications back, which is pretty good for an open recruitment process. You know, for the voluntary stuff, you would get less back. So, you know, we're in a good position. We had more applicants we had seats for. And what we did is we had 2 councillors from this committee, Councillor Singer, Councillor O'Connell, who did just like a first filter of those 12 applicants based on the criteria that we were after, and have recommended 2 new candidates, 1 to 4. 3 of whom are current Conservatives and 1 of whom is new. That's because the 4th one had run their number of years terms of office, so they couldn't stand again. You know, you're at will to recommend to the Executive Council another one, or 4 new ones on the list of the 12. But the idea of having a couple of councillors on the Scrutiny Committee doing that first filter meant that we weren't going to have a long discussion on who might go forward, but that's within your gift.
Okay. Thank you, Alistair. So,
you've been in a long meeting.
I wish I could just go home and go to bed. God, I've got another meeting later. Okay, so Councillor O'Connell and myself, as you say, form this panel. Removing my chair, just to let you know how we arrived at the decisions we did. Personally, when I read through all of the applications, not really looking at the names, just looking at the substance, 3 really emerged as amazingly strong, and they were the 3 current serving County Conservators. Between them, they had an enormous wealth of expertise, experience and skills. And so then I set about looking, I looked through the other ones, the other applications, in terms of applicants that could add to that list of skills. There were some overlaps, of course, but I was looking for another applicant who could bring something entirely different. And so it was that when Zoe and I discussed it, we reached agreement on this, and so the candidates we recommending our candidates 1, 2, 3, and 4. I don't know if you've got anything to add.
My approach was slightly different, but I arrived at about the same conclusion. I divided the candidates into three balls, yes, definite, maybes, and no's. All three conservative candidates, one through three, put in very strong applications. They were clear yeses. The less certain pool, I had a couple of people who could have made the cut. Number four was one of them, the other was number nine, in between us. Largely, my decision was influenced based on who else is on the panel of conservators. So, for instance, there's a large university representation already. So, that's why my decision in the end of discussion to number four.
So it's a non-key item. Unless there's any objection, I'm going to go to the vote immediately. Do you want to say anything? No. Okay, so the recommendations are okay, on the page. Please help me, James. Agree the recommendation of non-councillor appointments, applicants. Well, it's 1, 2, 3, 4. I didn't know that you had actually recommended those, so. I can tell you hand on heart that I arrived at those four entirely independently of any recommendation. So anyway, to agree the recommendation of non-council appointments, applicants 1, 2, 3, 4, see Appendix A, to the Conservators of the River Cam, commencing 1st of January 2016 with council's approval. 2, to note that council considers and approves the nominations of 3 city council appointments to the Conservators of the River Cam, commencing 1st of January 2016. 3, to write on behalf of the Council to those Conservators whose term will end, thanking them for their valuable contribution. All in favour? Thank you. Thank you, Councillor. Thank you. Wow. A roller coaster.